So students, in our last class under chapter reproduction in organisms, we were learning different methods of asexual reproduction in different organisms. Already asexual methods, we have finished discussing all the methods of asexual reproduction in different organisms. Now we have to learn another type of asexual reproduction, that is vegetative propagation. Vegetative propagation is nothing but asexual reproduction only, because in vegetative propagation also single parent is involved, but in this case in vegetative propagation it is reproduction in plants, it is asexual reproduction in plants. So vegetative propagation is asexual reproduction in plants because single plant, single parent, that is either male or female, directly produces offspring. So vegetative propagation is also asexual reproduction only because single parent is involved. So let us learn about it today in detail. So the chapter what we are discussing is reproduction in organisms. So if you remember in last class, we can just recap. We can just see what we have learnt in our last class. If we think about recap, we have discussed different methods of asexual reproduction. If you remember, we have learnt different modes of asexual reproduction in our last class, like either it is simple cell division in case of monerans and protists, where one cell divides into two, or else it is just a binary fission where one cell divides into two daughter cells, then two will divide into four, like that it continues, like as it is there in amoeba. Then in paramecium it is called multiple fission. Remember, this is not there in the textbook, but also I just told you they have mentioned under binary fission only amoeba and paramecium. Then budding is there, method where small outgrowth is produced. First it is attached to the parent, later it attaches, and on getting a suitable substratum it grows as new individual. That is budding in yeast and hydra. Then formation of zoospores in many algae and fungi, which are motile spores. Okay, then formation of, in case of penicillium, it is formation of special spores called conidia or conidiospores. Then in case of sponges in porifera, special structure is produced called gemmules, if you remember. These all methods of asexual reproduction we have already learnt in our last class. Today we have to learn about vegetative propagation vegetative propagation is also asexual method only, but you already know that word asexual is used for animals. The same asexual method, the word used in plants is vegetative. I have explained in last class why that word vegetative is used. So vegetative is also asexual method only because single parent is involved here. Single parent produces offspring. That is why it is a type of asexual reproduction only. So vegetative propagation is also asexual method only because single parent is involved. Single parent produces offsprings. If two parents of opposite sex are involved, then it is sexual reproduction. Male and female will be there, then it is sexual reproduction. Here it is either male or female, anyone. So you know that we have learned in last class that whichever part of the plant except flower, because flower is a sexually reproductive part, except flower, root, stem, leaves, if they produce new plant, then they are called vegetative propagules. Do you remember? Those parts are called vegetative propagules. Means if root produces new plant, then root is a vegetative propagule. If stem forms new plant, then stem is a vegetative propagule. Okay. So each vegetative propagule in root, stem and leaves, they are called by different names. Like for example, rhizome is a modification. Rhizome is a modification in banana and ginger. Rhizome. Then it can be runner, it can be sucker, it can be bulb. Bulb. In textbook they have mentioned only these names. Example is not given. But if you want example, I can give. Like sucker. Sucker example you can take mint. Okay, runner you can take strawberry. Strawberry, runner. Okay. Mint has two species, okay, two different species. One species belongs to sucker, other species also belongs to rhizome. So rhizome or runner. So don't get confused. Example is not given in the textbook. They have only mentioned name of the vegetative propagules. Okay. Rhizome, runner, sucker, bulb is like, bulb is like onion. Onion is a bulb. Then it can be tuber. Example, potato you can take as tuber. Okay, then offset is one type of modification. Example, Icornia plant, which we are learning today about this plant. Icornia, also called water hyacinth. Beautiful blue color flowers will be produced. Aquatic plant which lives in water. Okay, so these are modifications. Like textbook has only these many. In 9th standard you have learned more. Corm is there, C-O-R-M, corm, like Amorphophilus. Suvarnagadde, no? Elephant's foot. Suvarnagadde anta karithara, mannu olagade ishtodu gadde sigtadu. You all have tasted it. Okay, it is used for making dishes like sambar, palli ela madtara adra. Okay, so that is Suvarnagadde anta karithara. That is called corm, C-O-R-M. These all names are not there in the textbook. So textbook alli iddirudella sikkapatte kalidu beda. ಅದು ನೀಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾತ್ರ ಕಲಿತರೆ ಸಾಕು ನಾವು ಇನ್ ನೀಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಲರ್ನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ವೆಜಿಟೇಟಿವ್ ಪ್ರೊಪಗ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸಸ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ನೋ ದಟ್ ರೈಸೋಮ್ ರನ್ನರ್ ಸಕ್ಕರ್ ಬಲ್ಬ್ ಟ್ಯೂಬರ್ offset, all these are stem modifications. Stem modification means stem produces new plant here, and modifications of stems are called by these names. Okay, rhizome in banana and ginger, sucker in mint, strawberry runner, tuber in potato, offset, Icornia. Okay, so all these are vegetative propagules. Like even in leaf also you can see, you have learnt in 10th standard. Now we will discuss in detail. In detail we will discuss about this. But present what you should know is vegetative propagules are like tuber in potato, tuber, sucker, mint, runner like strawberry, then offset, Icornia is example, then bulb like onion. Okay, so these are some of the examples. These all parts are stem modifications. They are nothing but stem, they produce new plant. Okay, so these are vegetative propagules. Now if you look at one more is there, no? Rhizome, what we discussed. If you look at these stem modifications, the speciality is In case of potato, tuber, already you know this. Potato, usually it will have structures like nodes. These all are in nodes. Special structure will arise, that small bud-like structure will be produced. You all have noticed it. Nodes will be like a scar mark. ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡ್ಸ್ ಏನಿದೆಯಲ್ಲ ಅದು ಒಂಥರ ಸ್ಕಾರ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಗಾಯ ಆಗಿದ ಥರ ಕಟ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಥರ ಇರ್ತದೆ. ಇನ್ ಪೊಟ್ಯಾಟೋ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೀನ್ ಇಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಡಾರ್ಕ್ ಬ್ರೌನ್ ಕಲರ್ ಕಟ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದೇರ್. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಲೀವ್ ಪೊಟ್ಯಾಟೋ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದೆನ್ ವೈಟ್ ಕಲರ್ ಬಡ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್. ಅಂದರೆ ಪೊಟ್ಯಾಟೋ ತುಂಬ ದಿನ ಹಾಗೆ ಬಿಟ್ಟರೆ ಬಿಳಿ ಕಲರ್ದೊಂದು ಬಡ್ ಥರ ಬರ್ತದೆ, ಹೀಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಕಾರ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಇದೆ ಅಲ್ಲ. ಓಕೆ, ದೆನ್ ಸ್ಲೋಲಿ ಅದು ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ, ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಅ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಐಸ್. ಐಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತೀವಿ, ಐಸ್ ಆರ್ ಐ ಬಡ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇಫ್ ಯು ರಿಮೂವ್ ದೀಸ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸೋ ಇಟ್ ಇನ್ ಸಾಯಿಲ್, ಅಂದರೆ ಈ ಸಣ್ಣ ಬಡ್ ತೆಗೆದು ಮಣ್ಣಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾಕಿದರೆ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಪೊಟ್ಯಾಟೋ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಐಸ್ ಆರ್ ಮೆಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಪ್ರಪಗೇಷನ್, ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಟು ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್. ದೀಸ್ ಐಸ್ ಆರ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್, ಸಪೋಸ್ 10 ಐಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ 10 ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್. ಅಂದರೆ 10 ಐಸ್ ಇದ್ದರೆ ಆ 10 ಐಸ್ನ ಕಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಮಣ್ಣಿಗೆ ಹಾಕಿ 10 ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. ಓಕೆ, ಐಸ್ ವೇರ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ ಇವನ್ ಇನ್ ಐಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ, ಇವನ್ ಇನ್ ಆಲ್ ದೀಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ರೈಸೋಮ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಜಿಂಜರ್ ದೆನ್ ಇನ್ ಬನಾನಾ ದೇ ಆಲ್ ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ ಟು ಮಾಡಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಟೆಮ್ ಮಾಡಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ರೈಸೋಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಇನ್ ಜಿಂಜರ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೀನ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಜಿಂಜರ್ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಸಿ ದ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಹೇರ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದೇರ್ ಆನ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್, ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರೂಟ್. ಜಿಂಜರ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಈಟ್ ನೋ, ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಕುಕಿಂಗ್, ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸ್ಟೆಮ್. ಅಂದರೆ ನಾವು ಶುಂಠಿ ತಿಂತೀವಲ್ಲ, ಶುಂಠಿ ಅದು ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸ್ಟೆಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಕಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯೂಸ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸ್ಟೆಮ್. ಆನ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಸ್ಟೆಮ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಹೇರ್ ಲೈಕ್ ವೈಟ್ ಕಲರ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದೇರ್, ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ರೂಟ್. ಸೊ ಜಿಂಜರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಸ್ಟೆಮ್ ಮಾಡಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್, ಬನಾನಾ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಸ್ಟೆಮ್ ಮಾಡಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್. ಹೌ ದೇ ಪ್ರಪಗೇಟ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮ್ ಇವನ್ ಫಾರ್ ನೀಟ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್, ಯು ಆಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೀನ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಸಪೋಸ್ ಯು ಪುಟ್ ಒನ್ ಬನಾನಾ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್, ಯು ಸಿ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ 2-3 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ 5-6 ಬನಾನಾ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಅರೌಂಡ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್. ವೆರ್ ಎವರ್ ಯು ಸಿ ಬನಾನಾ, ಒನ್ 3-4 ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಟುಗೆದರ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಪುಟ್ ಒನ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್, ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಮೆನಿ. ಹೌ? ಬೈ ವೆಜಿಟೇಟಿವ್ ಪ್ರೊಪಗೇಷನ್. ವಾಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ಜಿಂಜರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬನಾನಾ? ಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್, ವೇರ್ ಎವರ್ ನೋಡ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್, ನೋಡಲ್ ಏರಿಯಾ, ಒನ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಅರೈಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಸಪೋಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಬನಾನಾ ಸ್ಟೆಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ಹಿಯರ್ ಅಟ್ ದ ಬೇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್, ಅಟ್ ದ ನೋಡ್, ವೇರ್ ಎವರ್ ನೋಡ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಅಟ್ ದ ನೋಡ್ ಒನ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಲೆಟ್ ಅರೈಸ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಲೆಟ್ ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಟಚಸ್ ದ ಸಾಯಿಲ್, ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಟಚಸ್ ದ ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸಸ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್. ಲೈಕ್ ಇಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟಚಸ್ ದ ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ಸಪೋಸ್ ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ಇಸ್, ಇಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟಚಸ್ ದ ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ದೆನ್ ದಟ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸಸ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಮೆಥಡ್ ಆಫ್ ವೆಜಿಟೇಟಿವ್ ಪ್ರೊಪಗೇಷನ್. ಸೊ ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್, ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಅಟ್ ದ ನೋಡಲ್ ಪೋರ್ಷನ್, ವೇರ್ ಎವರ್ ನೋಡ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಅಟ್ ದಟ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಒನ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಅರೈಸ್, ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಔಟ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಟಚಸ್ ದ ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸಸ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ದೇರ್. ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್ ಮೆನಿ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಅರೈಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಟಚಸ್ ದ ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸಸ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್, ಇವನ್ ಇನ್ ಜಿಂಜರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇನ್ ದ ಸ್ಟೆಮ್ ಮಾಡಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್. ದೆನ್ ಇನ್ ರನ್ನರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಒನ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ಸಪೋಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಸಾಯಿಲ್ ಸರ್ಫೇಸ್, ಒನ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ಇಟ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ದ ರೂಟ್ಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್, ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಒನ್ ಅಡ್ವಾಂಟೇಜಿಯಸ್ ಸ್ಟೆಮ್, ದೆನ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಟ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸಸ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರೂಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ರನ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಸಾಯಿಲ್, ದ ಸ್ಟೆಮ್ ರನ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಯಾರಲಲಿ ಟು ದ ಸಾಯಿಲ್, ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ರನ್ನರ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸಿಲೆಬಸ್. ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸಿಲೆಬಸ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ನೇಮ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್, ರನ್ನರ್, ಆಫ್ಸೆಟ್, ಬಲ್ಬ್, ರೈಸೋಮ್, ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ನಾಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯು. ಯು ಇಫ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಚೆಕ್ ದ ಟೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಬುಕ್ ವಾಟ್ ಆಲ್ ವೆಜಿಟೇಟಿವ್ ಪ್ರಪಗ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್, ದಟ್ ಮಚ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ನೋ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಟ್ಯೂಬರ್, sucker, runner, offset, bulb and rhizome. But this explanation is there. How exactly the stem produces new plant, especially in ginger and banana, that is in case of modification called rhizome. What happens small at the nodal portion, wherever node is there, one small plantlet arises and it touches the soil and produces new plant. Andre ondu sanna nodal portion inda ond sanna plantlet andre gida tara bartade adu hogi mannige touch aadmele hosa plant barutade. That is how it produces. Now we are learning one example for offset, that is called Icornia. There is a speciality about this plant, I have to tell you. The speciality of this plant is, it is a example for offset. Offset is a vegetative propagule. The modification is, the plant name is Icornia. Okay, you can write NEA also, Icornia. It has several names. It is called scourge of water bodies. Scourge of water bodies. You know, meaning of scourge means something which you cannot get rid of, something you cannot eliminate completely. ಸ್ಕರೇಜ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಯಾವುದನ್ನು ನಾವು ಪೂರ್ತಿ ನಾಶ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಅದೆಲ್ಲ ಸ್ಕರೇಜ್. ಯಾವುದನ್ನು ನಾವು ಪೂರ್ತಿ ತೆಗಿಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಅದು ಕರೇಜ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸ್ಕರೇಜ್ ಆಫ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಬಾಡೀಸ್. ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಟೆರ್ರರ್ ಆಫ್ ಬೆಂಗಾಲ್. ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ಸ್ ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ವಿಚ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಟೆರ್ರರ್ ಆಫ್ ಬೆಂಗಾಲ್. ದೇ ಕೀಪ್ ಆಸ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಟೆರ್ರರ್ ಆಫ್ ಬೆಂಗಾಲ್. ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಟೆಲ್ ಯು ವೈ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್. ದೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ water hyacinth. Water hyacinth means beautiful plant. Okay, so Icornia plant is a weed, means unwanted plant. It is a weed on water because it is aquatic plant which lives in water. It's an aquatic plant which lives in water. The speciality is, it is not an Indian plant at all. It is not from India. It is exotic plant. Exotic means it was brought from other country to India only because it had beautiful blue color flowers and beautiful leaves. The plant looks very beautiful because of beautiful flowers and leaves. Plant was introduced in India, means this plant is not from India, they have brought from other country to India because the plant was very beautiful. Leaf and especially flower was blue color, very beautiful it looks. Okay, so they brought it to India, they introduced to India, then in India it caused a havoc, means it created problem in India. What is that? It grows very fast. Grows very enormously on water. On the surface of water, andre neerina melmai mele, on the surface of water, on the topmost layer of water, it grows enormously. Enormously means you put one plant. Okay, after some days the whole water will be covered by Icornia. Then neevu ondu gida hakidre neerin mele thumba neerin Icornia gida agi neerina melmai ella muchi bidutadu. It completely covers the surface of water, so that the problem is it drains oxygen from the water. This plant drains out, means it gets absorbs all the dissolved oxygen present in water, then all the fishes present in water will die, because you know that fishes or aquatic animals living in water require dissolved oxygen. Adare neerinalli iruva jalacharagaligella karagida aamlajanaka beku alva usraadlikke. So the aquatic animals which lives in water, especially fishes, they need dissolved oxygen. But all the dissolved oxygen will be drained by, means taken by eicornea. Then what happens? It results in death of fishes. Okay, so very important for exam point of view. It drains out dissolved oxygen from water and causes death of fishes. It causes death of fishes. Okay, that is the problem. And you know, if you think you have removed all the plants of eicornea from the surface of water, one or two small part remains and again it starts reproducing. So completely you cannot remove or eliminate this plant from India. That is why it is called scourge of water bodies, terror of Bengal, because it is like a terrorist, or terror means, you know, one who creates fear. Okay, that is what we call terror. What, how it creates fear? It creates fear in water, that it creates it will result in death of fishes, because it drains out all the dissolved oxygen from water. Okay, so all the fishes will die. This is one problem. That is why eicornea is called terror of Bengal, water hyacinth. Hyacinth means beautiful. It is beautiful plant, but not good. It is a weed, means unwanted plant. Weed and now kannadadalli kale anta karithi. Kale means in arecanut coconut plantation, in between some plants grow which we don't want. Okay, wherever farmer is growing crops, crop plants, some unwanted plants grow in between. That is called weed, unwanted plant. Okay, so this is also unwanted plant, but we can't remove completely. That's why it is called scourge of water bodies. Because it looks beautiful, it is called water hyacinth. Because it drains oxygen and leads to death of fishes, so it is called terror of Bengal. Okay, so now, so one more is there, like this is stem modification. Even a root modification is also there, like that. Like that, vegetative propagation also occurs through leaf or leaves. Especially, you know this in 10th standard you have learned. Especially plant called bryophyllum. Bryophyllum leaf. Naam enta Brahma Kamala anta karithivalla. Okay, bryophyllum. Like Ratki Rani we call. Because the flower blooms only at night. ಅಂದರೆ ರಾತ್ರಿ ಮಾತ್ರ ಅರಳುವಂಥ ಹೂ, ವೈಟ್ ಕಲರ್ ಫ್ಲವರ್. ಬ್ರಯೋಫಿಲಮ್, ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಬ್ರಯೋಫಿಲಮ್ ಲೀಫ್, ನೋ, ದ ಬ್ರಯೋಫಿಲಮ್ ಲೀಫ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್. ಬ್ರಯೋಫಿಲಮ್ ಲೀಫ್. Okay, textbook picture is not given. I am drawing this for your understanding. These are the depression. What is there? No depression, where it is deep. That is called notch. Wherever notches are there, it produces small adventitious buds. Means it can produce one leaf-like structure, or it can produce one small branch with three leaves like this. These are called adventitious buds. So one leaf can produce many like this, and each part can produce new plant. So farmers make use of this property and they exploit this property commercially. Commercially means for making money. Exploiting means, you know, taking maximum benefit. What they do, they just cut this part and sow it in soil, new plant is produced. So like, suppose it produces on all the notches, okay, on all the notches it produces, like suppose 10 notches are there and 10 adventitious buds are there, they will just break and remove and put it in soil, then 10 plants can be produced. So farmers use it farmers make this property, they exploit it commercially. Commercially means for making money. They exploit it commercially. And you know that vegetative propagation involves single parent here, because single plant is producing offspring. See here, leaf of one plant. Two plants are not required. Male and female is not required. So single parent is involved here. Single parent is involved. Okay, then usually asexual method, it occurs only in organisms having simple body structure, means in lower organisms, vegetative and asexual, both are same. So asexual method usually occurs in simpler organisms. What is simpler organisms means? Like single celled organisms, their body structure is simple, single celled, like or it can be algae, fungi, or protists. Either it is single celled, or in some algae, some fungi, in some protists, some monerans like bacteria and mycoplasma. In these simple organisms, asexual reproduction occurs. But algae and fungi are exceptional, because in algae and fungi, only during favorable season, means when environmental conditions are suitable for reproduction, then only it will undergo vegetative propagation. Algae, fungi, under favorable conditions, then only it will undergo asexual method. But same algae and fungi under unfavorable conditions. Unfavorable means when environment is not suitable for reproduction. Andre reproduction maadlike yavaga vatavarana environmental conditions andre vatavarana sariyagi irudillo aa time alli it will undergo sexual reproduction. Remember, because algae and fungi, they have asexual reproduction also, and also sexual reproduction. Algae shows all vegetative, okay, that is asexual method, and also sexual method. Fungi also shows vegetative and sexual. When they show vegetative? When conditions are favorable. When conditions are not suitable, then they show sexual reproduction. Remember, okay. So next method what we have to learn is sexual reproduction. Okay, so sexual reproduction, if I start teaching, then it will take lot of time. I don't want to teach half. So we will discuss sexual reproduction in next class. Okay, so keep watching my classes. Thank you.